Van Viljoen. Good afternoon to you. Thank you so much for coming through.
Hello, Belisa. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much indeed. Of course, your response to the previous package, some organizations very much concerned about the funding model of the SABC, saying that it needs to be changed.
Indeed, indeed. The previous, in the inserts, there was talk about the cost of our mandate, and the cost of our mandate is approximately 2 billion rand per annum, anticipated to carry on at that level for the next 2 years, versus the funding that we get for that mandate is about 1 billion for the TV licenses and about 200 million for the government grant that we're getting at this time. So clearly there's a gap. Mm. That gap is meant to be funded from successful commercial activities. Those activities have not been successful in the recent past, and that's where we're currently trying to engage in business plans where there's much more commercial focus with return on investment more guaranteed.
And then we heard what the lady from SOS had to say on the previous package, to say that as soon as the SABC gets attractive content, mm, then there will be, you know, much revenue for it.
Indeed. Indeed. It's a bit of a catch-22 currently. Because of the financial constraints, we're unable to procure the kind of content that the audience requires, because the audience then migrates to whether it be other platforms, digital, or just don't watch anymore. You don't attract advertising revenue as well. So it's really a vicious circle, and we need to start investing in our content.
So in terms of TV licenses, that's the TV licenses fees, that's another area of concern. Mm. What are you hoping to do to change the situation? Mm. Because the reality is people are not paying their TV licenses. Mm.
Yeah, it is a problem that's got a few aspects attached to it. One is to address the culture of non-payment by instilling, you know, the hashtag made possible by you and the right reason to do these things for. But if you don't have content that attracts people, then it doesn't motivate them to pay. Alternatively, we're also looking at proposals around changes to the regulations. And the reality is, furthermore, that TV license fees, 72 cents a day, haven't been increased in 5 years. It's lost complete traction or comparability with CPI, I think 10 years ago. So vastly underfunded as far as that's concerned.
Mm-hmm. But really, one other issue that has created a panic in the corridors of the SABC, it's the news going around that it looks like the SABC will not be able to pay its salaries at the end of November. How true are those? My experience with the SABC for the past 12 years I've been here is that there's never smoke without fire.
Well, maybe these people who are spreading rumors know something I don't. But to execute the payroll is the very first priority when it comes to payment priorities. So even if the funds are significantly constrained, if we need to cut, that's definitely not the place where we take funds from. So literally in order of priority, it's the payroll. It's then the kind of things that ensure we remain operational. In other words, I call it lights and water kind of stuff. Mm. And then everything else follows from that.
Yeah.
So no, the rumors are certainly not true as far as I know at this time.
And I'm just going to ask you to respond to the media reports we've been reading about the retrenchments here at the SABC. Mm. And many people really saying that, look, this was one of the conditions that was set by the Treasury Department back in 2009 when the SABC needed a guarantee to say, look at cutting staff costs. Mm. So are we there?
We're at the point in time where we are firstly interrogating every single cost driver in our organization. The biggest one next to the content is the payroll. We will be remiss in our duties if we did not interrogate that specific line item as well. We are at the beginning of a process in terms of section 189. It really hasn't even started officially yet. So
has it not started, but we do know that some people's contracts were not renewed.
There would have been processes that informed those renewals or non-renewals at this point in time. It's not necessarily as a result of Section 189 that's pending or not.
All right. So let's talk about what you call borrowing limit approval, mm, that we call a government guarantee. So you're saying it's not a government guarantee. Yeah. School us a little bit on this one.
It's definitely not a government guarantee. It is not a bailout. It's not any new money that we're getting. What the SABC got is approval to, on the back of its own strength, which would typically basically be your assets, your balance sheet, etc., to engage with financial institutions that may have an appetite to engage with you as well, to see if they are prepared to lend you money in some shape or form, or make other financing modalities available to you. So no new money. All one specific initiative is far advanced, but it really just allows us a bit more predictability in terms of cash flow. No new money, no fresh money, no extra money.
But is the appetite there from your financial institutions?
Yes, yes. I'm encouraged to say that there certainly seems to be support for us in the financial institution environment, or at least a willing ear.
The willingness is there. So when are we likely to see things rolling in terms of getting money? I mean, the SABC is sitting at what, 1.3 billion rand debt as it is.
Yes. Yes, that is where we are as of about 2 or 3 days ago. Look, if it, I had my way, it would be yesterday, but there's processes that needs to be followed, and we want to make sure that no questions can be asked about these processes. So maybe in the next 2 or 3 months, we'll be able to have some sight of the success of some initiatives that's in the pipeline.
All right. And as I said, Yolanda, that there's panic in the corridor, the SABC staff, the morale is low, if I can say that, due to the financial situation that the SABC finds itself in. What would you say to the staff members? What would you say to the public who rely on the public broadcaster for information and entertainment?
I can understand that as a result of the history, certainly there's very little trust and no faith, certainly. But I do want to implore our employees and speak to the public of South Africa. Just give us a chance. I think by every single engagement myself or the COO, CEO has, we're at least transparent in what is taking place. The best I always say you can do is treat the other person with respect. You know, it's uncertain times. We're all uncertain. As I said, I don't know where it's going to end as well. But we must treat people like you want to be treated yourself. So work with us. I think there's been a lot of work being done that currently in-house, there's a lot of support for what needs to take place because the cost base is just bloated. We know that, and we need to do something about it, and it will secure ultimately the future of the organization.
Yeah, and going back to the previous package, one of the ladies talking there from SOS was basically saying that, look, this is a public broadcaster. Much funding should be from government as it is, and I do know that the executives were in parliament earlier this week. Talk to us about that. Do you think help will come?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's tremendous support, but unfortunately we all know that the economy is not in a space where money is just lying around. But the fact that there's lots of talks ongoing, specifically also across departments, if you look, for example, at the single biggest problem in one package is the cost of sport rights, and there are various parties that is currently putting in a lot of effort to see what can be done about that. We are then talking, going to start talks about potentially submitting a proposal for an increase in the TV license, etc. But yeah, I think there's support. It just takes time.
Yeah, yeah. And you talk of engagements and talks that are, you know, continuing between yourselves and other stakeholders. And you have the Minister of Communications who came out to say, look, I spoke to the board, I spoke to the SABC, I gave them advice on how to handle the situation, but it looks like they did not listen.
I wouldn't say we did not listen. We took the input that we received. We factored that into responses to her to enhance the submission we had done. And I do believe we have responded to all the suggestions that were made. We've taken cognizance of the input that we got, and I think we responded appropriately to it.
All right. We have to leave it at that. Time constraints, there's so much to get to, but we have to leave it at that. Thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Thank
well, you. There you have it. Many thanks to our CFO here, the SABC, Yolanda van Beldun, talking to us about the financial situation here at home and basically saying that, look, there's no need to panic. All right.